This is the TTS-160 Panda telescope mount. It gives you easy transport, quick setup without polar alignment, a simple and fast astrophotography solution. In this video, I will show you how you can take great long exposure astrophotos using the optional telescope rotator. I am Niels Hay, owner of Track the Stars. For this video, the mount is already assembled. You can see the setup procedure in another video. Note that absolutely no kind of leveling has been done. The pier has just been placed on the ground. The rotator is installed in the dovetail saddle with a big gear wheel towards the sky. The power and communication cables are connected. The main telescope and guide telescope are installed. It is important that both telescopes are placed on the rotator and rotate together. The best results are achieved if the guide scope points at the same area as the main telescope. As we are out for an imaging session, camera and guide camera is installed on the telescopes. Both cameras are connected to a PC. Now with everything installed and all cables connected, we can connect the power. When the power is connected, the rotator will start its calibration routine, where it rotates to each side and end in the middle position. Now we have completed the setup of the telescope mount and balanced the telescope. That means we are ready to make a two-star alignment that is needed for doing long exposure astrophotography. As we are going to take astrophotos, we will make a two-star alignment to get a good precise alignment. In this case, we will use Altair as the first alignment star. We select Altair on the handpad. When selected, the telescope is slewed by turning the handpad knobs until it points approximately at Altair. Using the camera live view on the PC, the star is centered precisely, and then the alignment button is pressed. This completes a one-star alignment that can be used for visual observation, but for precise imaging, a second alignment star is added. The second alignment star in this case is Vega. The telescope is slewed until it points approximately at Vega, and the camera live view is used to center it precisely. When centered, push the align button to complete the two-star alignment. Before slewing to the faint deep sky target, we use the second alignment star to focus both telescopes. In this case, we use a Batinov mask for the process, but other methods will work too. Having completed alignment and focusing, it's time to make a go to the target object. In this case, it is Measure 13, the Great Globular Cluster in Hercules. With the telescope now pointing at the target, it's time to frame it as you wish. Use the handpad buttons to slew the telescope. Using the step mode function makes this very easy. Now is the time to rewind the rotator. Select Rotator menu and the Smart Rewind function. Using Smart Rewind, the mount will automatically decide the correct side to derotate to. Next step is to find a guide star and calibrate the guider. Using a piggyback guide telescope with a small focal length means you will always be able to identify a suitable guide star. We use PHD2 as guide software. First, connect camera and mount. For the mount connection, ASCOM is used. Now start the guide camera. select a guide star and start the calibration. You can see how to set up PHD2 in another video on our channel. When the calibration is completed, guiding starts immediately. Now it's time to start the exposures of the main target. First, start the rotator via the hand pad. The asterisk shows when the rotator is on and tracking. Start the first sub-exposure. The system is set up for taking 30 seconds exposures in luminance, red, green and blue light. The mount and rotator will now track the object precisely for 1 to 2 hours, depending on the object position. Now our subframes are being stored on the computer. Relax and enjoy the beautiful sky and let the mount do the hard and precise work. When the rotator reaches the end, it can be rewound and started again. To do this, first stop the guiding, select Smart Rewind in the hand pad and start the guiding again. No calibration is needed. This way you can image the target for as long as you wish. The process of imaging and rewinding the rotator can be automated using programs like Nina or Sequence Generator Pro. With all the subframes stored on the PC, there is fun for many cloudy nights processing the final image. Check out our other videos at this channel to learn more about the Panda telescope mount. You're also welcome to contact me anytime if you have any question or need more information. Thanks for watching.